The prayer is the most important pillar of Islam after the Shahada, the two testimonies of faith. It is the prayer that distinguishes Islam from disbelief. Performing prayers is a sign of faith, and not performing it is a sign of disbelief and hypocrisy. Indeed, Allah warned those who neglect it or give it up. Allah says, "Then, there has succeeded them a posterity who have given up the prayers, example made the prayers to be lost, either by not offering them or by not offering them perfectly or by not offering them in the proper fixed times, etc., and have followed lusts. So they will be thrown in hell, except those who repent." Abu Ubaidah ibn Samit, radiallahu anhu, narrated that the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wasallam said, "Allah has made five prayers obligatory. If anyone performs ablution for them well, offers them at the right time, and observes perfectly the bowing and submissiveness in them, it is the guarantee of Allah that He will pardon him. If anyone does not do so, there is no guarantee for him on the part of Allah. He may pardon him if he wills, and punish him if he wills." Allah also says, "So woe unto those performers of prayers, hypocrites, those who delay the prayer from the stated fixed times. Allah ordered us to perform Salat timely." He says, "Indeed, the prayer is on the believers prescribed, at fixed times. But while being busy in worldly affairs, we often miss Salat from its preferred time. This is a major sin according to Quran and Hadith. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam said, "The first thing a person will be held accountable for on the Day of Judgment is his prayers. If his prayers are correct, accepted, he, she will be successful. But if his, her prayers are not accepted, he, she will be a loser." The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam also said, "Between a man and disbelief is abandoning the prayer, obligatory prayers." It is said in an authentic hadith that the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wasallam likened deliberately missing a prayer, without excuse, to disbelief itself, such as his statement, "Whoever leaves Salat has disbelieved." Abdullah ibn Bureida, radiallahu anhu, narrated that the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam has said, "The pledge between us and them is prayer, whosoever leaves it has rejected faith. Those who neglect Salat, they will enter hell. They will be asked, 'What has caused you to enter hell?' They will say, 'We were not of those who used to offer the prayer, nor did we feed the poor, and we used to talk falsehood, all that which God hated, with vain talkers, and we used to belie the day of recompense, until there came to us the death that is certain.' The primary reason for which they were admitted to hell is that they failed to offer the prayer. Those who miss prayer intentionally, he will be punished seriously in here and hereafter. Punishment for missing a single prayer intentionally, even if made up later, is hell for a long period." The Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wasallam said, "A person neglecting his Salat, even though he makes it up later, shall remain in Jahannam for a period of one huk. A huk is equal to 80 years of 360 days each, and a day in Akhirah is equal to 1,000 years of this world." Thus, huk literally means a very long time. In most hadith it is explained as being 80 years as explained above. Delaying the prayer intentionally is also a major sin in Islam. Many of us delay Asr prayer till nighttime because they are busy in playing or working. Doing so is strictly prohibited in the Holy Quran. Allah ordered Muslims to guard the prayers. He says, "Guard strictly five obligatory, as salawat, the prayers, especially the middle salat, Asr prayers." Umar, radiallahu anhu, narrated that the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wasallam said, "Whoever misses the Asr prayers, intentionally, then it is as if he lost his family and property." Fajr prayer can also be the most challenging for many Muslims. So, there are many hadiths that speak to the great reward and blessing entailed in waking up for Fajr prayer. The Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, "No one who used to pray before the rising of the sun and before its setting will enter the fire," meaning Fajr and Asr. Therefore, dear sister, you have to observe the prayers and perform them at the fixed times. Allah says, "Verily, the prayer is enjoined on the believers at fixed hours." Not performing prayers takes the person out of the fold of Islam, and delaying them from their fixed times is a sign of hypocrisy, so you have to be careful. In the life of a true believer, studying at the university or working is not more important than prayers, to the extent of being a cause for delaying them. A Muslim lives and dies for the sake of Allah, and strives to save himself, herself from hellfire. He/she should not have as a priority anything above the obedience of Allah and His Prophet. You have to know that on the Day of Judgment Allah may not ask you about your work or study, but He will ask you about your prayers. So you have to be very, very careful not to abandon the prayers or neglecting and delaying them from their fixed times.